Brent, y'all had a good start, really good start. We was talking about that. A lot of things, got getting outside, getting some turnovers on defense.
I mean, I think it, I mean, it's a good start, certainly helped. 27 points in the first quarter, that's, in girls basketball, I always thought it was a race to 50 if you played pretty good defense. So if you can get to 50 and hold the other team under, then I think you win a lot of, or able to win a lot of games. So 27 is about as good a start as we could ask for offensively. We were able to get a few turnovers early that kind of got us clicking, you know. I mean, anytime for us especially, it feels like we need that to start the game, to see some easy ones go in early to get to establish a rhythm and a confidence level that carries over to our outside shots.
Okay, individually, talk about Lindsey's game.
Lindsey did everything that you want in a guard. I mean, and it's not just, she had 23, but there's no place on here that categorizes or keeps up with value as far as running what you want to run and getting us under control when it's a little bit hectic and protecting the basketball, especially against hectic defense. And she was outstanding. I mean, I don't think it's far and away the best game of her career, you know, her 5 years playing. I mean, I think I was blown away. And I think she proved a point to a lot of people that about how valuable she is to us. We know that. Her teammates know that. Everybody in our group knows that. But I think she showed a gym full of people.
How big was the rebound? And you know, how rebounded by 14?
That's hard to believe because it felt like we were giving up a lot of offensive rebounds. But yes, I mean, I remember, you know, watching games growing up, and it's usually, I've told them several times, no rebounds, no rings. That's kind of been our motto as far as on that aspect of the game. If you don't rebound, you know, you can't win. I mean, you play great defense, but that's only half the battle. You got to rebound the ball. So to do that, that's pretty good. That's more than pretty good, actually. But it didn't feel that way at times. It felt like we gave up a ton of offensive rebounds. But it may have just been if they were just in succession, you know. When you give up two offensive rebounds in one possession, it's like somebody punches you in the stomach, is what it feels like. I know that's the way I feel.
Is it good playing somebody like Tupelo that can play hectic like that, especially
yes.
In the second half?
Yes. I mean, we came off. It was good for us to play them now because, you know, a week ago we played St. Martin, who their guards were athletically able to do the same thing to us, and we didn't handle it very well. We got shoved all over the court. We were not able to get it. We handled it much better, and that was the positive.
Lindsey, just talk about your game. I was telling somebody early in the game, I said, that's a story I need to get on Lindsey all because she's like the forgotten or unknown Falcon. I mean, not to any more people, but just with all the other names and stuff. Just talk about today's game.
Like you said, like, I blew myself away, honestly. And I mean, I know I'm capable of doing that, but my personality is so unselfish sometimes that I don't know. Like, the point-wise, I guess. I mean, I'm more of like a 10-point player, and I just look for assists more than I do shots most of the time. But I've just, these past couple weeks, like, I realize that this is my last, you know, my last go around, so I gotta do something before it's over and I have regrets.
I mean, the good thing for her, and I won't interrupt, but the good thing for her was when you sense that some of your other players that you depend on, you know, struggle a little bit, there has to be somebody to fill the void. That's what she did. I mean, she may say 8 or 10, but some nights, you know, you don't get a whatever points per game average or assists per game or rebounds per game. You don't just stay right on that number the whole time. It's going to fluctuate, you know, based on need today. I mean, I know the score was, you know, I would say, well, we needed that. She needed that.
Did you sense that too? That maybe somebody needed to step up and do some scoring? I mean,
if I do sense it, usually, you know, I still usually just back off, and I don't see myself, like, I don't know what I'm trying to say.
I think what she's trying to say is she sometimes has a passive personality as far as thinking that.
Yeah.
Like, it's not me.
You know, well, you know, go down the list of players we got. Well, she's going to do it. Well, she's going to do it. Well, she's going to do it.
Yeah.
I'm just going to let them do it instead of taking the bull by the horns.
Also, Thompson had a good first half.
She did. She shot it well. she shot pretty well. But I've threatened her a little bit. You know, if you're open and you don't shoot it, you're fixed to come out of the game because she shoots it way too well to be passing up shots. But I thought, particularly in the second half, I thought she rebounded it well because a lot of those, you know, spats that I was talking about where it felt like we couldn't get a rebound, she got up. You would see her come out of a crowd and elevate and go get it, and that's where you're like, yes, you know, because when you see somebody go get it, that fires you up, especially one that's not in your area, that's over there on the other side of the lane, you leave your area and go rebound it. That shows the kind of urgency you have.
And just one last one, I don't know if we've written about it, so I'm going to write about it and just talk about the losing Grisham. What she brought to your team, and now you know it was an ACL.
It was an ACL, and she brings the element to our team that we talk about the most, and that's, you know, toughness. And I know that's a popular word now with coaches, but I mean it really is. I mean, that's what I said about St. Martin. I felt like we missed her a lot that game just because it was her kind of game, because it was no old barred, you know, not a lot of fouls, no hand checking fouls, and that's her type. She's tough. I'm confident that she would have gotten offensive rebounds and stuck one back or got a steal and would have been able to make a difference in the game. That's the part that her grit, toughness, determination is what we miss the most with Carson.
I'm good
Thanks, guys.
Thank y'all.